I can't face these lies.
So, this is the second episode of the Barber'n'Bass podcast. Today I'm joined by Zylo. We're going to jump straight into a couple of questions, a little bit about him as an artist and a little bit about what he's got going on at the moment. So man, if you could just tell me a little bit about yourself.
So what a lot of people don't know, yeah, is that I actually come from the extreme sports side. Before I did music, I did extreme sports for quite a long time. I specialised in rock climbing, but I did everything. I did white water sports, I did sailing, I did loads of stuff, swimming. But yeah, not a lot of people know that one. It's quite of a, it's kind of a secret.
So then, if you came from that, I mean, how did you get into drum and bass? What was the
core drum and bass? I tell you what, yeah, it all started from house music, to be honest.
Okay, so there was house is where it started for
me. House is where it started for me. Whether it was tech house, whether it was bass house, I used to love it. Grungy. It was like the best. And then I used to hate drum and bass music. People used to play drum and bass. I used to be like, what the fuck? They turn it off. Like, it's disgusting. And then I couldn't even tell you what happened. I don't know. I feel like grew up, but kind of got sillier at the same time and started listening to drum and bass.
Okay.
I think cool. it was Liquid that got me into it. Yeah.
That's what
it
was kind Liquid. Of first,
yeah, I remember now.
That's what
it
first
was Liquid
you
drum and bass.
What, do you remember what the first song was that you like really. Do you remember the first song you listened to and you were like, this is.
I tell you
it,
what it was.
Me now. This is I like this genre.
Dawnwall.
Was it?
Dawnwall. I say he's yeah. Do you know what? He's one of my definitely one of my favorite artists as well. But yeah, Dawnwall. I think it was him who got me into just the whole. It was a Liquid side. I used to love the space of Liquid. How spacey it is. The drums. It weren't too much like dirty noises and stuff.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, it's like I personally find that Liquid is. Probably like more like the enchanting side of drum and bass.
100%.
And it's way more easy going. I mean, anyone can listen to a little bit of Liquid and you can listen to Liquid drum and bass and not be into drum and bass. Whereas
exactly.
You can't listen to all the dark techie stuff. And
yeah,
like
it's
really,
more
really
appreciative. A lot of people like listen. I mean, that's where it started. Yeah, Liquid drum and bass. And then I started making, like I said, I used to do mixes on my computer, but mm-hmm. with my trigger finger. And I remember messing around. And then, yeah, I just started getting into a bit more parties. And then the first ever set that I come across where I started really listening to drum and bass was a squat party in central London.
Okay, cool. And when was that?
This was probably about 2 years, but it's been more than 2 years. I've been saying 2 years for about 2 years. I'd say probably, a while back, 3-4 years ago.
Okay, cool.
And yeah, and that's when it hit me. I was like, wow, actually drum and bass is crazy. Because I heard it first time on like a big system.
Yeah,
bass,
yeah.
Do you know what I mean? And it hit me. When you listen to headphones and stuff, you can't really appreciate
it
as much.
You never really catch it until you're like
exactly.
in a venue and you get
and
like
you're feeling it, exactly.
It.
I remember feeling the drum and bass and I was like, okay, cool. All right, house, I love you, but drum and bass is going to have a little part in. And now I listen to more drum and bass than I do house.
Really?
Which is weird, yeah, because I used to love house music. I was all about my house music. I was like a house snob. And now I've become a drum and bass guy, so.
I mean, there is still that in the industry though, isn't there? There is still like that kind of, you know, that line between do you like house, do you like drum and bass, do you like tech, and do you generally find that the kind of two people don't interact with each other normally? Like,
mm-hmm.
I know a lot of guys are into house, and I can barely ever get them to listen to drum and bass. Like, it's
yeah, 100%.
They're so against it.
100%. And
the main thing I wanted to know is where did the inspiration for the name come from?
Like, Zylo.
Yeah, where did that come in? I mean, I speak to drum and bass quite a bit, and you know, you ask them about their names and. I've heard everything from, you know, that they just saw it to they took it from a track or it came to them one day when they was at a festival or something like that. I mean, where did you get the name from?
The Zylo name comes from all the way back in school. And me and my friends, we used to hack people in school, right? Mm-hmm. Hack Instagrams, hack Facebook, hack their whatever it was. It was just funny. And we used to do it under the name of Zylo Bings. That was the name.
Right.
Zylo Bings, like Bings the search engine.
Right.
It was Zylo Bings. We used to just mess around on that. And then I forgot about the name for ages. Like, it literally just completely switched my mind. And then I was at a phase where I was coming out of college and I was part of a group we called ourselves KRN. And I left college, and I was thinking, oh, I need a name for myself. Mm-hmm. Like, oh, I need to have my own name.
Yeah, and an alias.
An alias. And then I was with my girlfriend at the time. She was like, why don't you use Zylo? And I was like, oh, what the hell? That's crazy. I was like, I never thought of that.
I didn't even think that could be a thing.
Trust me. And then it just, happened there. And then, Zylo becomes Zylo.
Do any of the people that you used to run with and used to do the hacking, do any of them know why you've used that as that?
I haven't spoke to any of them from school in God knows. Probably last time I spoke to them was probably at school.
So it's been some time since then.
Yeah, it's been a while.
And I mean, so going forward from that, like what's on the map for you at the moment? What have you got coming up? Is there anything you're going to be playing at? Is there any like events we should be looking to see you at? What's your aim for the top off the end of the summer?
Oh, end of the summer. Well, we've got a lot coming up. I mean, my birthday's in October and I've literally got a rave every single weekend. One or two raves every single weekend until my birthday. I'm going full flat at the moment and I'm loving it. Like, I'm loving the underground scene. I'm loving just everything that I'm in at the moment is really good. Like, I feel like I've got a really good sort of path that I'm going down at the moment, which is a lot better than it was before. I mean, I'm moving to Manchester soon. Well, already kind of done it already, but full time moving to Manchester.
So you're moving out of the London drum and bass scene into the Manchester.
Exactly.
Drum and bass scene.
But the thing is, like, it's not like I want to go to Manchester and stop doing the London scene. Like, I know for a fact that I'm going to be in London and Manchester every single weekend, whether it's back and forth or whatever, but I can't wait. Like, Manchester is such a sick place to be. It's so cool. I've loved it. I've been there a while going back and forth. It's just such a cool atmosphere. It's completely different to London.
Yeah, of course.
And it's just that sort of fresh sort of, I can come in there and just go crazy. Do you know what I mean? And that's what I'm trying to do. I'm going to go there, do some mad stuff. I've got a uni, obviously. I'm going to uni there. So I'm going to be in the scene amongst lots of people.
Causing chaos, mate.
I'm going to go crazy.
Yeah, I mean, that's a good part of the scene. I mean, I think Manchester is quite an underestimated scene, and I think it's very much is on the toes of London, and it's definitely starting to make some noise for sure.
100%. It's only 2 hours down the road.
It's actually not that far. A lot of people underestimate how far it is and kind of what's going on up there. I think for sure it's definitely going to give London a run for its money.
100%.
Sooner or later.
100%.
In the next couple of months, or at least the next couple of years for sure. I think, you know, you'll start seeing artists. I mean, you know, Bristol's a big one.
Bristol's
got
home of drum and bass. Yeah, Bristol.
It was gonna be. I think the scene is changing. I think people are realizing that you don't have to just be in London anymore to be in drum and bass. That's not. Although it's the hub of it, it's not so much always the heart of it. So.
100%. I love London, but there's other places to be right now, as well as London.
Yeah,
so
of course. Yeah, definitely.
We're gonna smash it.
Yeah, so you're gonna be doing both then. You're gonna be juggling the two.
Yeah. And then anywhere else that comes up, but I'm just looking to take Manchester over, literally. Just gonna take over the underground scene.
So we should be looking for you at some Manchester-based rave.
100%, yeah. You'll see the name there.
Will they all be underground, or are any of them going to be mainstream?
Oh yeah, mainstream, underground. But the thing is, I'm going up there to focus on the underground scene, because people that I've been speaking to are saying to me that there's not really much that goes on around Manchester, where it's underground scene. I mean, there's house parties, there's raves, but it's not like it's we all, do it out
yeah,
here.
Yeah,
like
yeah,
we do
yeah,
it out
course.
Here crazy. And that's what I'm looking to do. And to be honest, I've been up there quite a lot already, and I've already found some sick spots to have a rave in Manchester. That, 10 times as good as London. So I'm just waiting now to get up there, get some planning done, and then...
And get involved.
Get it involved, bro.
Cool, man. Sweet. Cool. So, I mean, the next thing I want to know, realistically, you know, is kind of every question you put to most DJs, is if you had to go back-to-back with someone, like your... Other than picking your mate or, you know, the DJ that you like playing with, if you could pick a dream back-to-back set, who would it be? Who would it be and why?
I say it and then I'm like, I don't know. But yeah, I'd say Turno because I love everything that guy stands for. He's such a sick person and also a sick DJ. Like, the guy, every set that I've seen, or everyone that I've seen on YouTube and watched myself, like, crazy stuff. Like, the way he gets the crowd going... It's just a dream, isn't it? That's just the way it is. The way he does it, sick, clever guy. And the music is on point.
Is that the way he produces or is that the way he mixes? Like, what's
both.
The,
like, his both. Production. His production's quite, like, literally incredible. The stuff he can come out with, most disgusting stuff. Like, it's crazy. And then his DJing, it's just the crowd control I get with him. Like, the way that he can bring people up, bring them down. I think that's one of my inspirations. I'm not even going to lie to you. I'd say that with me, always try and do a journey with my mixes, yeah. And that's with Turno, that's what every time I watch his stuff, like his journey, it will bring people up, smash them around for a bit, bring them down again, then bring them back up again. Do you know what I mean? It's just, that's clever. It's clever stuff. He's a clever guy.
So then would you say he's your favorite artist, or would you say that like he's just one of your favorite DJs to go and see?
He's definitely a favorite artist of mine. But then the thing is, I've got loads of favorite artists, like Becky Safe, sick DJ, sick, everything she does, everything she stands for, absolutely love.
Yeah, she just recently been signed, man, so she's...
Crazy stuff.
She's artist thing now, so she's definitely been coming up. I mean, that's the thing, that's what I like about the industry at the moment as well, is there's a lot of new faces coming through.
100%.
Some people have been around for time, some people that are just now starting to get the credit they kind of deserved originally. Like, there is some new exciting stuff kind of coming up at the moment.
Yeah, I mean, my guy Alchemist, in the underground scene, we've got Alchemist at the moment. That guy's killing it, man. Alchemist, absolutely love him. He's a cool guy, sick guy. And he's killing it, bro. Like, he's getting everything that he deserves, and he deserves it, so fair play to him.
Cool, and then talking of artists, who's your favourite non-drum bass artist? So if we're talking outside drum bass world, what is it kind of stuff you listen to, and artists that you like when you're not producing or listening to drum bass?
My favourite artist non-drum bass is going to be a girl called Alice D.
Okay.
A girl that I'm working with at the moment. Incredible artist, honestly. Incredible. Her voice, the way she holds herself, absolutely incredible. Literally stunning, beautiful girl as well, absolutely crazy. But her voice, it is, I don't know, it's something about it, it just captures you. Like, trying to think of the song, I'm so bad with track names, but there's a song that everybody knows and everyone sings, and it's got the most peacefulest voice ever. And yeah, her voice sounds like that, incredible, literally, absolutely incredible. LSD, sick.
Check it out.
Literally, Alice D, check her out.
What genre of music is that? What is
She's chilled, like, hip-hop, like, R&B, chilled vibes. She's on a house track with me at the moment.
Oh, no way.
Coming out soon, yeah.
Of course, so it's a completely different vibe from the drum bass then.
Completely different.
And I mean, talking of tracks then, what is, you know, you're playing your set, you're going to do your set shortly. What track would you not go into, like, would you not be able to do your set without? Like, what is your go-to track? It's on every single, it's on your USB, it's always the one you reach for straight away.
It's gonna be Mackie G Dirty. It's right. Because that tune, every time I drop that tune, yeah, the crowd goes wild. Like, the reaction you get off that tune, incredible. Absolutely crazy, every single time. Honestly, I've played that song. I played that song. I don't know how many, like, since it came out, and every single time, without fail, it will go crazy. Everyone will just be like, "Whoa!"
Mackie G's favorite fan right here. That's what we've got. that top song.
Literally.
And I mean, another question for you in terms of, like, you know, spaces and whatnot. If you had to pick a venue, say your favorite venue, you know, that you would love to play at, not experience, but something to you, right, you know, you've made it, that's it now, you pick one venue to play at, this is your dream place.
I know the exact one, Printworks.
Printworks.
Printworks, man.
Why Printworks?
That's
an unusual choice, I think, you know.
It is, because I did a couple of jobs there before, light and sound tech, and but I experienced it, like, behind closed doors.
Okay.
And the history that place has, the history.
The actual
oh my goodness,
itself.
Crazy. Like, the back doors, there's this piano in there, this old piano, grand piano. And I was playing on it, and the guy came up to me and he was like, yeah, this piano's been here since this place opened. And that place has been open for such a long time. I used to print all the newspapers. And yeah, the history behind that place is incredible. All the corridors, crazy stuff. I even found in this back room, there was this Coke bottle, like Coca-Cola bottle, and it had turned white. Like, that's how long it had been there. It had turned white, and he said, yeah, like, this room has never been used. Like, no one ever goes in it. It's been shut for all this time.
No way, really?
Yeah, literally. Like, it's crazy. Like, all the back secret doors, absolutely crazy. The history of that place is sick, and it's just such a cool atmosphere. It's like a long, what is it? Like a long corridor, isn't it, really? If you think
so
about it.
It's got this mad kind of history involved.
History, vibe, just sick. Everything about
just
it. Sick.
In the venue itself, like, mm-hmm. people wouldn't normally get to experience.
Exactly.
Oh man, I mean, is it you've been there a few times then?
I've worked there twice now.
Cool.
Yeah, I worked there twice I used to set up events, so working as like crew team, setting up lights and sound and making sure everything's safe. So yeah, that was good. That was a good little vibe, man.
And I mean, that rolls into something else I have for you, is that if you weren't focusing on the music so much right now, like, what what else is it you'd like to be doing? Is there anything else that you'd be like, this is what I'd be doing if I wasn't so heavily involved in music?
I mean, I said before,
alternative career path.
Yeah, I mean, I said before I was in extreme sports. I did all my extreme sports, so okay. I specialised in rock climbing. Literally any extreme sport you give it to me, I was doing it. I worked for loads of different places, loads of cool stuff like Wales and Scotland and all these cool places. But yeah, I love sports. Like rock climbing is, yeah, I love it. It's so nice.
For you.
Yeah, yeah.
And do you ever kind of participate in it now? Like recently, do you ever get back into it, or is it
when I've got the time?
You let go of it.
When I've got the time, I mean, I'll always go. But yeah, it's like time management these days is crazy.
Yeah, it's hard. I
don't have enough time for myself these days.
It's hard. Yeah. Hard to get everything in.
Exactly.
Oh, cool, man. I mean, it's I think it's mad that there's this kind of other side to drum-based artists and kind of other stuff they have involved in. I think there's a lot of artists now, and they've kind of got these little side projects and stuff that they're working on alongside the drum and bass that they're doing. You know, everyone's got their other little like personas and things that 100%. Kind of makes them about what they're about.
I mean, when I was young, I always knew I'd be in something musical, whether it was DJing, whether it was making music, whether it was just anything. I knew that I was going to be involved in music because I've always done music ever since I was a kid. So yeah, music, if I didn't have music, I don't know what I'd do.
I don't know what I'd be doing.
I'd be doing rock climbing, but I wouldn't be happy.
Yeah, exactly. You'd be doing the rock climbing, but you'd be doing the music to it as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, wouldn't be happy.
It'd be music first, rock climbing second.
Yeah, literally.
Cool, man. Well, we look forward to hearing your set. We're going to finish up with this and we'll...
I can't wait.
Get you onto the decks, man, for sure.
Let's do it.
What's going to be the first track of the set? What's going to be the first track we're going to hear?
In for the kill. The classic banger. Cool, but with a little twist.
With Kid.
We'll be right back. Sound of man. We'll be right back. down to the bone. To the bone.
need you to come closer. Just because I want to get to know you. Let's talk or maybe exchange numbers. There's a whole world that I wanna show you. Real girl, I need you to come closer. Just because I want to get to know you. Let's talk or maybe exchange numbers. There's a whole world that I wanna show you. And if things go nice, then we could be in love. And if things go nice, then things might happen. We could be in love. And if things go nice, then we could be in love.
Rude boy, you look like a smoker. What's wrong with you that don't got no wisdom? I can feel the stress that you're under. Can we go and trash it on the sofa? Rude boy, you seem like a joker. Can I bother you for a lighter? Is it alright if I ask for your number? I don't want you to come a bit closer. We'll be right back.